CRISPR-Cas and the new borderline cases of plant genetic engineering. CRISPR-Cas is a new approach in genetic engineering. But can it produce plants not genetically modified as well? Researchers claim it can, in order to avoid legal constraints and public concerns. Are they right? This is a typical plant. And this is a typical plant protein. It may serve as a plant building block or chemical tool and will determine some of the plant's features. Each plant has a large number of such proteins. Genes are storing the information for these proteins. All genes together constitute the genome, which is transferred from generation to generation. Genetic engineers insert new genes into plant genomes. These new genes may be derived from any organism. Even bacteria are possible donors. This difference to classic plant breeding was the main cause for security constraints to genetically modified plants. The term genetically modified addresses all organisms with genetic modifications not possible by natural means. Genetic engineers are also able to switch off individual plant genes. Up to now, this was only possible by inserting specific suppressor constructs into the plant genomes. Due to the presence of such constructs, the plants were assessed as genetically modified. CRISPR-Cas also uses suppressor constructs to switch off specific genes. These constructs, however, are inserted into plant genomes only temporarily. They are removing the genes to be switched off from the genome. Subsequently, they are removed themselves by means of conventional breeding. This constitutes a relatively complicated borderline case. The plants produced are not different from normal plants, since genes can be switched off by conventional means as well. With the current definition, these plants are not genetically modified, although they are derived from genetically modified precursor plants. Will we keep the current definition of genetically modified plants, or should legal constraints be imposed on every application of genetic engineering? For which reason should we do this? Such questions only address a part of plant genetic engineering anyway. Many aims in plant genetic engineering can only be reached by inserting new genes into plant genomes. The resulting plants will be classified as genetically engineered independently from the technical approach used for the insertions.